Okay, so here's your opener.
Shall I go?
You start.
Are we going to go with the traditional beginning?
Dang, 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 dang. With your arm in my face.
Hello and welcome to this, our latest and new video, brought to you slightly more professionally with Gav, not behind the camera this time.
Yes, a YouTube first.
A YouTube first, yes. Mini-me is here.
Me online. Skinny Gav, as someone called.
Skinny Joe.
Skinny Gav, that they were.
As my mate calls you, because he doesn't really know your name.
No, that's fine.
So this is Gav, I'm Joe, and welcome to our vintage toy shop. This is going to be our, we've been asked this many times.
Yes.
What's your top five favourite toys?
So it was really hard to come up with top five.
Mine is going to change. I've written this list here, and it's going to change again. So here it is. Here's our
number five. Here we go. My number five. Tomy Robots.
Tomy Robots.
Yeah. 1984.
He's off.
He's off already. Everyone recognises this guy. Omnibot is in the advert.
Omnibot can play music, serve food, and break the ice at parties all at the same time.
Everyone wanted one. $250. No one had one. But they released the little ones, which are wicked. This is Dingbot. This is my very first Dingbot. I had him probably in like 1984 when I was little. It's very cool. They make a hideous sound when you switch them on. But we tried it and, you know, they're old. They don't work anymore. Ooh, watch that.
Have your eye out.
Yeah, have your eye out on that.
So Vive la France.
Yes.
French version.
He's nice. I've had it. He's quite recent to my collection, actually. I've got nearly all of them now. But yeah, look how cool he is. It's just Dingbot. In blue, but how nice is he? How nice does he look?
And doesn't go yellow. Bonus.
And bonus, yeah, because you can see compared to the others, he is a bit nasty.
The radio cassettes were all the rage in the '80s, weren't they, Gav?
Yeah.
Here we have. What's his chatbot?
Chatbot, yeah. He's got a little remote, and you could record your own voice and drive him in and terrorise your sister.
Brilliant.
Or anyone. They all do different things. This guy here, he is by far the most rubbish looking one of all of them. But he's an actual little hoover, little vacuum cleaner. Sucks up the dust off your desk. Or so they say.
He certainly does suck.
Oh, that's not nice, is it?
Oh, no. Where's the big one? You've got the big ones as well.
Oh, Omnibot 2000. I couldn't lug that in this morning. It is massive.
Didn't bring one to bring him on your trolley.
Not really.
Hello, human race. I'm Omnibot 2000 and I've come to serve you.
Imagine that walking through the street.
On the bus. You have to get him his own ticket.
Yeah. But yeah, Omnibot 2000. And he was, I think he was like $600 or something stupid like that. No one had on for 2000.
It's a very left field number five, Gav, but I like them very much.
Cool.
Through the magic of television, or maybe the magic of magic, we have magicked my number five here, which is Lego. I love Lego. It's universal. And that was actually a Lego thing, wasn't it, for a while? Universal.
Was it?
Yeah, you could buy Universal Lego.
Oh, Universal Monsters. They did Dracula and stuff.
What, in Lego? They did?
Yeah.
Good point.
Good. Little Wolfman.
Because Lego has covered so many things, don't call me that again, by the way. Lego has covered so many things, that's why I love it. But the vintage stuff especially appeals to me because it's what I remember when I was a bit younger, when I was buying Lego when I was really too old for it. And some amazing stuff. The train sets are fantastic.
Out of the kitchen and off like a flash. If it doesn't slow down, it's going to crash. But down in the docks, they have what it takes to get on the train and put on the brakes.
You've got space stuff, you've got castle, wherever your imagination could go as a kid, you had something to cover it. And now, the same situation is now. We have all this amazing history. And we've got new sets, amazing. We've got the Death Star up there and some fantastic stuff. The Star Wars range is brilliant. The Lord of the Rings range is now really collectible and exciting. My favourite thing, though, is this.
It's beautiful.
My shop display, which is a bit dusty, it's been on display. It isn't for sale.
Should have perhaps given that a wipe.
Well, you know, the amount of times I hear that. But I don't know, I love it. It's not for sale, so don't ask, because you'll be told no. It's one of those things, there's not much in this shop that isn't for sale, everything's for sale.
But that's
lovely, that's a special thing. So Lego is my number five because of its universal appeal and because I'll always go back to it. And you know when we get Lego in, I will always want to build it.
Good thing with it as well, you don't even need the sets, you can just have the Lego. Yeah. You build what you want.
Build what you want when you're a kid, but for me now, when we get like Lego in, I'm not building this stuff, and it's like 3 o'clock in the morning. I'm thinking, I've still got to build this thing.
It does take longer than you think, doesn't it?
You can lose hours.
Imagine
hours.
That Death Star. How long would that take?
Days. So we built some of the bigger sets before at home, and it was like you were spending like 2 days on it. You're thinking, this is 2 days' work here. But it's brilliant, and it's such a great toy.
It's big.
Yeah. You're sort of there putting it all together, and it's 100 quid, and you're like, oh, is it really worth it? But yeah. So Lego for me. Because you can spend £2 on it and buy a really cool minifigure, or you can spend thousands and buy mint sealed vintage stuff. It's an amazing toy line.
My toy number four, the biggest star of 1986, Alf. This amazing alien puppet. Lived with a family, chased the cat, tried to eat the cat. Awesome. I love him. Used to watch him on TV. That's it, really. There was nothing quite like him.
You've got hundreds of them.
Oh, I've got loads. I've got a mountain of them. I've got a very big sofa, but at least a third of it is Alf's. My mountain of Alf's. Like, it was merchandise to death. It was like everything, lunchboxes, T-shirts. It's kind of like the Baby Yoda of 1980s. But these ones in particular I like. These are Burger King. I can't imagine they'd have been like giveaways. I don't know, like Happy Meal type things. But they're amazing, you know. You've got baseball Alf there, Rockstar Alf, this guy here as well. And I'm amazed his little cardboard sunglasses are still there. He's brilliant.
Cooking with Alf.
Look at him, look at that moustache.
Oh, yeah. It's like he's more European, like French. He's brilliant.
There you go. And this dude here.
Yeah.
Coming in.
I've genuinely not seen these with tags on before.
No. I was quite pleased to find these.
Yeah, these are cool, man.
Yeah. But yeah, we love Alf.
Where did you snag these from, Gav? On eBay?
No, it was Toy Fair sometime.
Really?
Some time ago, yeah.
They're beautiful, man.
Yeah.
Awesome. Really love them.
There's a really good talking one, which I really should have bought him, but I doubt he works still.
You couldn't fit him in anyway.
No.
Like with all your electronics, do you store them in like Jason's shed?
Yeah, the dampest place.
Covered in wood louse, and then the rest of it's damp.
That's it. We try them, they never work.
Oh, Alpha, even I remember, and I, as we know...
Joe didn't have a telly, famously.
I mean, we could set up like a perhaps account for that, how many times I didn't have a telly. But I was aware of Alf, and I thought he was amazing.
You couldn't not be aware of him, he was everywhere.
No, he was everywhere, yeah. And it was 1986, so it was junior school, end of junior school for me. So
everyone's got the T-shirts and the underoos, probably.
Yeah. Well, I don't know about that, I didn't have the underoos. I wasn't allowed novelty underwear.
Really?
That I wasn't allowed.
Deprived childhood.
Yeah, well, it was just not that I wasn't allowed, it was just they were more expensive.
Oh, okay.
So, yeah. So, no, I didn't have novelty underwear.
There you go.
Made number up for four. It now, though, people. My number four top toy line is this weird obscurity, the LJN Tiger Sharks. Ask me why I like them, Gav.
Why do you like them, Joe?
Haven't had them before. Pretty much addicted to them. I love them. They're brilliant. I don't know really anything about them because, as I've said before, I didn't have a telly. I had nothing to do with this, but I thought I'd shoehorn it in. But yeah, the Tiger Sharks, because they're all the LJN, so Thundercats really I'm very cool. fond of, they could have been in there. But Tiger Sharks are because they're kind of like Thundercats, but very different. And they are just cool. These are all graded ones, which is something I'd like to have them loose, complete myself, but they are awesome. And I love the fact there's lots of unproduced things on the back as well. They had plans, but sadly they didn't come to fruition. Yeah, and like how Sergeant Pepper's
is
he?
Yeah, it really is.
I love it. I love that. It's for me, toy lines that you don't see very often, particularly in the UK. So in the States, you're kind of going, yeah, I've seen them before. They are hard, but I've seen them before. But in the UK, we don't get these at all. So, absolute favourite. How cool is he? T-Ray. He's just
look at that
epic.
Face.
Yeah.
Oh, and his helmet.
Yeah.
Oh, his helmet's amazing.
There's just a lot to love about him.
Yeah.
And he's a very cool figure. Yeah, very cool. And then we've got Mako, who is my latest edition. I think Mako is the latest one I've had. These are for sale.
You don't want to sell them.
I don't want to sell them. But yeah.
He's a funny looking one.
Spike Marlin's my least favourite. He's a bit too generic.
He's not sharky enough.
No, he's not. But at the same time, there we go.
Not amphibious.
So it's one of those toy lines. It was kind of like unfinished. And I think I love it because I don't see it. And I don't know. This top five, I've got to say, They'll change, won't they?
Oh, yeah. It's probably changed since we wrote the list.
Yes. By the time you see this, we will have changed our top five, because it's sometimes with toys, it's about what you love. I think my top two are very firmly, however, in there. I don't think that will change. But I think my last three, the sort of, you know,
wavering
five,
about.
Four and three, which is coming in soon, they're going to probably flip about. But these, right now, these are my number four.
Number three, Pocketeers. Released in Japan in about 1975. What's it, Palitoy took them on, released eight in this country. They're just awesome. They're, you know, this so close to being my number one Pocketeers was, but it just got pipped at the post. But they're brilliant.
By
they're
two
like,
other things.
By two other things, yeah. As soon as I said that, then I was like, But they're brilliant. It's like way, way before Game Boys, before even Game & Watch. There you go, slot machine. This one here is particularly rare. It's the blowpipe one, because everyone would lose all the little bits. There's not many of them about. I've not even got the proper box for that one, because it's that hard. They did a crossbow as well, very similar.
Yeah, crossbow.
Crossbow's cool, isn't it?
Yeah.
My favourite one, though, and it's dead simple. How cool are the boxes? Look, you slide them out like that. Space Invaders. Literally. They move about like that. And you had to shoot the little thing at the top and get a score. Hours I played on this. I was a very simple child. There you go. That's as long as you get. Get that long to play it.
You got to restart it again.
Start again. Reset the clock. But yeah, grab some brilliant. Pocket money prices as well.
Yeah, they were everywhere in this area as well. Where we're from, Palitoy is not far away, a few miles away. Yeah. So they were everywhere in this area.
They were. I need about three more and I've got them all.
Mm.
Good collection. But there's loads more, there's loads of American ones as well. That's what's going to end up being the next thing
thing. Yeah. That's the good thing with collecting, you see. Yeah. It's how far you go with it. Do you collect just the UK release or Japanese release?
Yeah, Japanese, it's crazy. It's about 170 odd of the Japanese ones. Whew. Really good Pac-Man one. That'll be the first one. And then that'll be Slippery Slope.
Danger. Danger. Danger.
That's it. But yeah, there we go. Pocketeers.
My number three is... Oh, these Transformers! I absolutely love them. I mean, they're so cuddly. They're
sharp,
so huggable.
And cuddly.
Sharp and cuddly. I love Transformers. As a kid, though, I didn't. So this love affair has happened. Well, since I've been dealing in toys, the first ones I got, I thought, oh, that's all right. But then, as I learnt more about them, and as I've spent more time playing, sorting them out, I just absolutely adore them. I've got big hands. So it's not, as a child, I was like, transform, people bring them into school, I go, can I, just broken now. You can have this back, I don't want it. Give them my Star Wars figure back. But I absolutely adore them now. The fact that they were so cool as toys, that Hasbro took them on and made a cartoon, there's all that to it, all the history that goes with each one as well.
Sideswipe, grapple, ratchet, jazz, a whole army.
Evil Decepticons, Autobots, Transformers.
These are pre-Transformers.
Oh, these are awesome.
So this is what we would probably call jazz, but it's brilliant. This is an Italian box one, a gig box, Porsche 935 Turbo. But yeah, it's just jazz, and that's all they did was repackage. It's brilliant. And you could do anything. So Pretenders, they were a great toy line, part of the Transformers world. That's Pretender Starscream. So you've got a transforming robot inside a shell. And then you've got Action Masters, which were like an action figure. They do fall apart. That's what it kind of fell down for me. Action Masters are really cool, but they did kind of...
They do look really cool, though, don't they?
They
display well,
yeah,
but perhaps not for play.
And this was in the gold plastic era, so you have to treat these with the maximum care, because they will break. If I start taking this apart and changing it around, it will break. But I love them. Right down from the Headmasters, you know, this sort of guy's a Headmaster. So is a Brainstorm over there. That's a sealed one. And then they've got the Classics range as well, which are now showing some love. This Optimus is beautiful.
Yeah, the gold box.
Unused. And Combiners, I could talk about all day. I love Combiners. Because you could buy them in gift sets. You could buy them individually. You could buy the little card ones.
Mm-hmm.
So much play value.
For me, just mini bots.
Yeah.
Little mini bots. Look, Sea Spray. Iconic.
Pocket money toys.
Yeah.
Pocket money toys at the time. So the Transformers, because of how... much ground they cover.
That's it. You had cars, you had robots, you had boats, you had guns.
Yeah.
Everything.
You could play anything with Transformers and you could kind of fit them in with another toilet. They are brilliant. My favourite is Scorponok. Ask me why.
Why Scorponok your favourite?
I like the colours.
Fair though. He's very cool. He's green and purple. It's a winning combination.
It's a green standout, you know. Yeah. It's like my Campri ski jacket in 1987.
This is more more that colour though. This blue guy here.
Oh, yeah, yeah. It's again a combiner, you see.
Yeah, he's proper shell suit colours.
They are brilliant. Brilliant toilet. So Transformers, I love them. They are my number three and they will only go up.
Oh, that was one of your sayings, that is.
Yeah, is it?
Yeah.
Point price.
It'll only go up.
Yeah, it's true, yeah. I do say that a lot in the shop.
Number two, Cabbage Patch Kid Poseables.
You said number two.
Always a card. Specifically the Poseables. Back in about 1984, when Cabbage Patch Kids were at their peak, went to Zodiac Toys in Leicester. And they had the full-size doll. It was a little bold American football guy. It was amazing. But we didn't have enough money for him, so we ended up with Poseables. I was up till 2 a.m. last night trying to find my childhood ones, and I'm really disappointed because I had one character, little Brian. He was a little bold guy. He's my favourite. I'd love to have had him here, but...
You've got me.
We got Joe. He's close. Little bold guy.
Not little. Brown hair, red hair, no.
They were in all countries. They all had their own names as well. Who we got here? Clementina. Kim Clementina. They all have weird little names. What's this one?
She married to a rapper.
Sounds like it, doesn't it? Oh, this one's French. Bonjour. Augie Brett.
Augie Brett.
That's not a very French sounding name, though.
It sounds like
Augie. Oh, yeah, Augie. I guess
it is.
That's
something your grandma would make you for breakfast. Do you want some Augie Brett?
Augie Brett. But I love them because they're all different. All different little hair. And they did say when they were released that every single one was completely different. Not strictly true, but there are a lot of different ones.
And they've all got dates of birth on them.
Yes, they have. And the dolls themselves, you had a birth certificate with each one that you had to fill in and send off. So you had it's like your own little baby.
I bet you were the talk of the school when you were turning up with that. No, I can't do that today, lads. I've got to send off all my birth certificate. Cabbage patch.
But one thing they did do, which... people are weird with these. Cabbage Patch Coosters, and they were like animal versions, and they've got really strange faces. But just recently, I found out, and I managed to get some. They made little poseable versions of these, and they're so weird.
This,
I was really excited, yeah. And I bought a few of them, and they're only available in America. You couldn't get them over here, and they got such weird little faces.
Basically. It looks like one of these after your cat's eaten it and then hocked it up.
Yeah, bit of gene splicing. But like, it's holding a little bird.
I went to school with
But look, that. that's going to eat that little bird. That's not cute, is it?
Is it going to eat the bird?
It looks like it. It's a cat. Oh, is it a cat? What should it look like? Gills? I don't know. I have no idea what this is.
If your cat's got gills, it's not a cat.
No. But there we go.
Bring the authorities.
I love them. Absolutely love them. There were a few 80s girl toys that I considered, but yeah, Cabbage Patch Kids is what took it.
Could you not have gone for something left field? It's like the one thing we have in the shop, and occasionally you might sell one.
Yeah.
But these are ace. And I like the fact that they've got the different birth certificates on. And it's been signed by the chief of staff.
Yeah. Xavier Patch. He's the main man. He's the man who discovered
him. That's not his name.
Yeah, that's his name.
Oh, my Lord.
He was the one who discovered Cabbage Patch Kids in the Cabbage Patch.
Yeah, I think you bought into this too much, haven't you? But like, that was February the 14th, 1984, and this was January the 18th, 1984.
Yeah. So,
That
was a productive Cabbage Patch.
It was, yeah. Very productive Cabbage Patch. That's it. We're at my number two. Here we are. And it's the first time I've looked down for quite some time with some pride at one of my number twos. But here they are. Star Wars and the vintage variety is definitely... Are you all right?
Yeah, go on. Carry on.
Sorry.
With your toilet humour.
Oh, I'm sorry. I'm basically a child. That's why I still collect toys. Anyway, for the other people going, oh, he's done it again. Right. So... vintage Star Wars for me, because this was, as a child, this was my thing. And it was what started me off buying toys again and dealing toys again, was vintage Star Wars. This is where it all began for me. And they did everything for vintage Star Wars as well, whether it was a pencil sharpener.
Oh, yeah.
You could buy stuff that you could buy for your pencil case. You could buy everything at school you had was Star Wars stationery.
It was sort of the beginning of major merchandising, wasn't it?
Yeah, there was things before that, but not like Star Wars. Not where it was scale. Everything. Bed yeah. sheets. We've got some envelopes over there. I mean, who would like, yeah. you know, yeah. I better send in a Star Wars envelope.
Underoos again, the yeah. second mention of the video.
Underoos, yeah. Same with them. There's some of those available on Facebook Marketplace there is, yeah. now. Yeah. John Baldwin's got a load of them. Mm. Very nice.
They're really cool.
Anyway, that's enough of that. We're chatting amongst ourselves yeah. now. this is a proper YouTube video we're meant to be doing. There we go. Droids as well. Oh, these are mine. These aren't going anywhere.
I really want these myself.
Every time I've had them and I've sold them and I've kind of like always afterwards I've gone, I'd really like them again. Mm-hmm. So these two aren't going nowhere. They're mine. I brought them from home. But yes, so I love Droids toy lines. Ewoks as well was amazing. Rubbish, but amazing. Yeah. And then we've got things like the 3PO carry case. We've got the 12-inch figures. You had the monsters. You had the diecast. You had everything Star Wars yeah. that you could get. And then we came down to the figures. There's so many to collect. There's so many different variations of figures, which some people's boat.
It's silly now, yeah.
Yeah, we've got a Meccano Chewbacca sat on the front there.
Chikitaba.
Yeah, Chikitaba. He was in ABBA. Which a lot of you didn't know. Vintage Star Wars is definitely my number two.
I was talking to my dad last night and he was really surprised that Star yeah. Wars wasn't in my list at yeah. all. And it's a weird, because like, at some point, as we've said before, yeah. it'll probably be right up there.
Yeah, this will change.
Yeah.
This will change. But for me, this is my
yeah.
solid number That's... two. There's another poo joke there. this is like, for me, this is definitely my number two.
Yeah.
The C-3PO tape dispenser as well.
It's the best thing in yeah. the shop.
And then we forgot the jacket. We need to get the jacket.
Oh.
So when you
were... We have featured this before, but...
In the fan club, you could get yeah. this. And like, look at it. Oh, it's just awesome. Imagine wearing that. Imagine it.
Just imagine.
Oh, Gav could probably wear it now. I definitely couldn't. No matter how much I diet, I'm not going to get into that. So yeah, it is what came about. So every toy within this toy line, with probably a couple of exceptions, I absolutely adore. So the cardboard stuff, Palitoy Death Star.
Yeah. Oh, it's a shame we didn't have one of them for the video.
Well, yeah, and the amount of times we've had them in, we've yeah. not got one
next,
now.
Next time we have one in, we'll do a video about that.
Yeah, because yeah. that is, you know, that's just so cool. Yeah. Don't even start me on Palitoy cardboard, it's amazing. and like the speeder bike, I mean, this, as a kid, the play value in this.
The speeder bikes battle it out with these terrific Star Wars models. Adjustable cannon, manually operated speed flaps, breakaway front end. Who will triumph in this daredevil race against all odds? Only you can decide.
Of the fact you could just press the button on the back, like, that I mean I'd never seen the films when I had these toys, by the way. Never seen them. Had no idea who was goodies, who was baddies. Yeah. I mean, I was still not sure on some of them. But the toys, I absolutely love them. I play with them with absolutely everything. Every toy line.
Speed bike is so common, yeah. but it's one of the coolest things.
Yeah, I mean, like, well done.
Yeah.
You know.
Well done, toy designers. Yeah. Well done.
Well done. That is a beauty. And that's just because the playability of it and the amount of fun. And they were pretty hardy as well. They didn't break.
No.
I mean, the re-released Power of the Force one, that sort of yeah. rubbish. By comparison, it was
very similar, but...
Oh, it was the same moulds, yeah. but they didn't put as much... So you put it, you stand it up, and it would never stand on its legs.
It wasn't springy either, was it?
No, it was just...
Yeah.
It looked a bit pants. But yeah, so vintage yes. Star Wars, for many, many, many reasons, is definitely in there.
It's where most people start their vintage collecting.
Yeah. This is what set me off.
Yeah.
It's where my heart really lies with buying toys. And it's kind of like... It changes so much as well with the online thing.
Yeah.
It's changed so much.
It has. And I think that's what sort of forced it out of it for me. It's kind of been ruined a little bit.
It's been exhausted, hasn't it? Because of the amount of, you know...
But then, as I was saying, when I went and got this out, it's like, you get that in your hands and you're like, oh, that's the best thing.
Yeah. They are awesome.
Yeah.
They are brilliant. So, yeah, Star Wars. Yeah. Vintage. Vintage Star Wars is definitely where it's at.
He's not going to stand up.
He is.
Here we go.
They have confidence. Like a Tommy robot, just rolls on.
Here we are, toy number one.
These are our number ones, people. Number one.
Number one. Mad Balls. My absolute favourite. Soon, whenever they came out, Check my cheat sheet, 1985.
Mad balls, gross for one, gross for all. We play with a mad ball, they're gross, funny, yucky, sick. There's eight, so you can take your pick. We throw, catch, it's fun. There's so much gross in every one.
Parents absolutely despise these toys. Not because they were gross, because when they first came out, they were rock hard balls. And, oh dear. And like kids would throw them at each other, at the face. And so what they did, they brought them out again, spongy, but they're still really hard. Yeah. They'd still do you some damage.
I don't think time's been kind, has it? Because no. I think they went firmer over time.
Yeah, in fact, that'd probably do you less damage than that one.
That one really hurt.
But this is sort of my main collection. I've got all the balls loose, but I'm desperately trying to get the carded ones.
Which is why we're going to America, by the way.
It's purely so I can get mad balls. Yeah. But this guy here, Wolf Breath, is my favourite. Because I love horror stuff anyway. He was awesome. He's a little werewolf. What more do you want? But yeah, great.
But why didn't you put the figures in? Why didn't the figures make it?
I'm a purist. Just the balls.
Okay.
And you know, you've got the big balls.
Right. So
there's three of these. This is Touchdown Terror. And they did
imagine it getting hit with that.
Oh, no, that'd really hurt.
That'd really hurt, that would.
And there was a basketball one and a... What was the other one?
Baseball? No.
No, a little one baseball, wasn't it?
Can't remember. Sports, isn't it?
Sports.
Not your thing.
Not my thing.
And it's not my toy line, so you should know this.
I should know this. That's it. I'm under pressure. I can't remember.
But yeah, mad ball.
Yeah, there was another big sports ball of some kind.
So did you get these when you saw them in the shops? How did you feel?
Oh, like you just saw him. It's like, look, gross. I love gross toys. Look at him. His eyes coming out. He's slobbering. Slobulous. And they have brilliant names. Slobulous. Ah. Hornhead. Fantastic. Lock lips.
They are brilliant.
They're absolutely brilliant. Yeah, my favourite toy line of all time. And that will probably stay at my number one, to be honest.
So essentially, we've got to a point now where we've just got, quite simply, your number one toy is a ball that's been drawn on. I mean, I know there's more to it than that, but it is the same. But that's kind of it.
That is it, yeah. It's very simple.
Marbles were the first toys, really. And then, well, you know, certainly early on. Mm. And then mad balls were kind of still a continuation of that. But essentially, Gav, they're quite simple, but complex.
Yes, simple, but very complex.
Yeah. I summed that up well.
Very kind.
So this, people, is my number one. Fisher-Price Adventure People. They are without doubt solidly in there at number one. They are my favourite toy line, and it's the one thing I remember, apart from Star Wars, as a kid, playing with for hours and hours and hours and hours. And you could play with them with everything.
Fisher-Price presents...
The Adventure People!
Toys for your older kids. There's the Northwoods Trailblazer, ready for his adventures. Or the daredevil skydiver to go as high as a child can toss him.
There were some curious things. The stance was weird. They had got like a sort of
a little weird hand.
And the bent arm. The one hand like that. So they could use one calculator, one digit at a time. Or hold a handbag.
A giant plastic calculator.
And they also had the bent leg thing going on. So it was a little bit... But I love them. And the fact is, you could get... I mean, this is a kit. This is an unused kit. So you'd build this up and spend your time...
Oh, wow.
Like this guy, look.
Yeah, I didn't know that was what it was. That's pretty cool, isn't it?
These were all kits you could build. Got all them. At home.
I love them. They're such good figures.
And then you had the fit. I mean, this, as a kid, I got... So everybody had this. Everyone. If you had Star Wars, you had this. It was kind of came free with it. I don't know, or something. It obviously didn't, but it's just... The Alpha Probe was a brilliant, brilliant toy. This is a used example, but it's lovely.
For most people, the guy was missing.
Life support cable
for spacewalking and docking.
Looks great. Now for the crucial test.
The Electronic Alpha Probe by Fisher-Price.
The closest thing, really, that you got in that size to the actual space shuttle itself. So the Alpha Probe was up there. This, I've put this out across, because this stuff's really cheap. You can buy this stuff for not a lot. This is a sealed... unused example, and it's the most common one. You can pick these up for about 35 quid if you shop around on eBay. Brand new, unused. This is one of mine. Comes with free dust. It's been on my shelf. But it's a fantastic set, and I loved playing with that as a kid. But my favourite thing is, without doubt, my Canadian market shop display. Oh, I've only just had this, so I'm totally in love with this. Yeah, it kind of. I drove with it to work this morning in the passenger seat, and I kept looking at it. I think this is dangerous. I can't keep looking at it, but it's in my room near my computer. So,
I do think you should fill it though. I think you should get a fully full.
I'm gonna.
Yeah, good.
I'm gonna. I've decided that's gonna happen.
So good.
I've already got three of the X-ray lady.
Yeah.
I think there's another one knocking about somewhere.
They're my favourites, the X-ray people.
Well, the one you want to get is there's Brainiac and things like that.
They're chunky, aren't they?
They're amazing figures.
Yeah.
Even though they've all got this sort of same.
Yeah.
There is, what's it, motorbike guy who's got two.
Oh, two. Two of the hand.
No, he's got two proper guns. He's properly.
Yeah. You got your Star Wars Link as well.
Yeah. The first Star Wars figures, they were modelled off these. That was what they came with. Then the catalogue in 1977. Yeah.
That's how they presented them to the,
There we go.
To Lucasfilm. This is what we're going to do.
Yeah.
They look rubbish.
It looks terrible.
The Chewbacca.
Yeah. Whoa. It's really bad.
It's like they glued some fur onto one of them.
But I love this toy line, and I've got many happy memories as a child with mum going to buy these as well. So it was, and this was, I know I'll never stop with this stuff either. I'll just keep buying it because. Yeah. I just can't help myself. It's like an illness, everyone. I'm addicted to buying Fisher-Price Adventure People.
That's toy collecting in general, though.
Yeah,
isn't it?
And I'm very good generally. I'm very good. I am quite restrictive with what I buy, but Fisher-Price Adventure People is my Achilles heel. It is the one thing when I see it, I've got to have it, even if I've already got it. But there we go. Yeah, so that is definitely firmly in at my number one is Fisher-Price Adventure People, my favourite toy line ever.
Brilliant.
Right, so that's it. That was our top five.
There we go.
It's all over. That's it, folks. We hope you've enjoyed watching the video. What's your top five? Let us know in the comments below. And don't forget to...
Yes, subscribe, like the video. Details of all the social media and eBay and everything all below.
We'll see you on the next video. Thanks very much. Goodbye. See you soon.